Hi, I'm Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making bacon candy. I thought this would be a good time of the year to introduce you to bacon candy. First, I'm going to show you my bacon. We have 8 slices, thin slices of bacon, and I'll show you the package. It doesn't have to be this brand or this type. It can be thick slice, it could be applewood smoked, whatever you want. Mine happens to be Fisher's Melwood bacon, and you can see that in a package there's about twice as much as what I have on my broiler pan. I have 8 slices, and I think there are 9 that remain here in the package. So I'm using about a half pound, with this being a 1 pound package. So I have prepared my broiler pan, and I always cover it with aluminum foil so that it is a very easy cleanup. And I put slits down through the foil. I'll let you see that. I just use a knife to put slits through the foil so when the bacon starts rendering and making grease, it will drop down to the bottom and be caught by the aluminum foil there, and just so easy to clean up. Now you have to do this one layer at a time, so that's 8 slices at a time, and if that's all you need, then you're done. So I'm just doing a recipe for 8. But if you want to make loads of bacon candy, then you'll need to multiply my recipe by 2 or 4 or whatever. Into a small bowl, you're going to put 2 tablespoons of light brown sugar, and that has been firmly packed, but it's 2 tablespoons. To that, we're going to add cinnamon, 1 teaspoon. Then we're adding nutmeg, 1/2 teaspoon. Next, we have coarsely ground black peppercorns, 1/2 teaspoon. And finally, we have 1/4 teaspoon red cayenne pepper. Now, if you don't like things hot, you might want to reduce this or just leave it out if you don't like the idea of having red pepper in with your sweet treat. But it's going to be sweet and spicy, but it's going to be hot also. And as I said, you can cut down on the heat if you'd like to just use 1/8 teaspoon instead of 1/4. Then that will be enough for you to notice that it's there. So I'm going to get this together, and here is our blend of sugar and spices and peppers. So we're just going to come over to our bacon, and you may put as much or as little of this as you like. If you want it very much candied, then put a lot on each strip. I would check to see the limits of what I have, so I would probably just run through each one of these and give it a little bit, and then I would try to even things out. So I'll work on that, and I'll come back to you with this ready to go in the oven. I decided to use all of the mixture that I had for the 8 slices, and after I got them covered pretty evenly, I took my fingers and kind of pressed along each one so that it would make good contact with the bacon. So this goes to a 350 degree oven, and we're going to keep an eye on it. It probably will take 10 minutes or so, and if I feel like the back side is getting a little more done than the front side, then I'll rotate it around, things like that. But I will come back and tell you what we did to get our bacon candy. Here's our candied bacon that is sizzling straight from the oven, and it has a little bit of topping there that is greasy. I'd like to get the grease off, but I don't want to remove the topping. Let this sit for a while, just rest and cool a bit before we make it into bacon candy. My caramelized bacon has cooled enough for me to work with it, and I try to remove any excess grease that I can get along the way without taking off the topping. And what I want to do is just cut this in squares. So I use kitchen scissors and just try to make them square. They don't have to be perfect or anything, but they're full of flavor. And then we're going to let them cool completely by placing them in a dish like this. It doesn't take a very large dish for us. So I'll bring these over and just put them in. And then I have some work to do here by cutting those into squares. Here's our finished bacon candy, and it's still a little bit warm. And actually, if you're serving it as slices of candied bacon, you want to serve it warm. But if you're using it for another purpose, maybe as part of a decoration, then you would want it nice and crisp, and that happens as it cools down. I'm going to pick out a couple of these and take a bite and see what we have, just for flavor. It's not all that crispy right now. The flavor is good. I don't have a problem with bacon at all. You know that. I love bacon. So I'm tasting for all the other flavors. It's spicy and it's sweet and it's hot. Not too hot. Let's try another one. I think this one's a little more crispy. Yeah, you can hear the crunch. And that's what I like. Tastes really good. It tastes like Christmas, holiday season. It just tastes like this time of the year. One thing I might mention is that when you take these out of the oven, if they just are not crisp at all or not crisp enough, put them back in. Or one thing you can do is after you cut them with scissors, then you can put them on a plate in little pieces and put them in the microwave and watch them very carefully, using 30 seconds at a time on half power. And those will come out perfectly for you. But I just love these. If I can save them long enough to actually use them on something, I don't know about that. Really a good flavor for bacon. I want to show you a gift that I received recently because it pertains to the video that you just saw. This gift is from Alan Kent of Blackpool, England. And I want to show it to you. Here it is. It's a book, the title being I Love Bacon. And he sent a couple of cards with it. And this is a really pretty card, personalized to me. Happy birthday, Betty. And on the inside, he has had the card company print out what he wanted to say to me and in wishing me happy birthday. And then he also enclosed a postcard, which is personalized to Betty, tells the meaning of the word, the name Betty, and also has a special message. This book has over 50 recipes, and I haven't had a chance to read it yet, but I'm so looking forward to it. The only kind of book I really read is a cookbook. I'm not really much for novels. I read for information mainly, but my favorite thing to do is read cookbooks, and I can read them from cover to cover and never get bored. So thank you, Alan. I really appreciate your thoughtfulness. I will use this. I will make something that is a recipe from this book at some point. And for those of you that might be interested in what Alan does, he has a channel where he has uploaded a few videos. So if you want to see those videos, click on this link up here, and it will say Alan Kent, or Alan Kent's channel, or something like that. But the name of his channel is Alan, A-L-L-A-N, Kent, K-E-N-T. And his recipes are very healthy, very good for you, and he tells you why. So I'm sure everybody will enjoy visiting his channel. Thank you again, Alan.